Associate in Fine Arts students and the instructors. And at the end of the program, Ms. Cecilia Wright, who is the program coordinator of the program, is going to share some closing remarks with you. This is a fairly new program. It's been in existence for about 3 years, and it's growing. And so I'm excited to hear them tonight, and I'm especially excited because I have not been able to get into the Christmas spirit. So I'm hoping by the end of the evening, I'm going to be ready for the holidays, and I hope you all will too. Enjoy.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Tika Douth, and I'm the ensemble director here at Forsyth Tech. So glad to be here tonight to perform for you this evening. Thank you so much for that wonderful introduction to you, except we only have been in operation for 3 semesters. We are a very baby, young group, and we're just kind of getting our bearings, but we're really excited about how we sound and what we have to offer this evening. I do want to take a moment to acknowledge 3 people that accidentally were left off the program. Christian Orr on trumpet, Tracy Martin, who's a recent graduate of the Forsyth Tech Early College on trombone, and Gabrielle Miller on so I just wanted to make sure that you know these guys are up there playing with us. And we're gonna change the order of the program just a slight bit. We're gonna begin with the holiday mashup, which is a beautiful, beautiful medley of 2 songs that you'll recognize. I don't want to give them away because I want you to recognize them. And then we're going to follow that with It's a Most Wonderful Time of the Year and close out with a Christmas festival. Okay? So we hope you enjoy it. If you're into it, if you want to sing along, because these are all Christmas carols, please feel free to join in. It's all about getting in the Christmas spirit this evening. Thank you so much for coming tonight.
Thank you. shepherds, why this jubilee? Why your joy of strange prolong? Say, what may the tidings be, which inspire your heavenly song?
Yes. Stevie Wonder is. He started out, of course, as a child star, and Logan will be not only singing this evening, another special treat, he will be accompanying himself on guitar, and he will be doing the famous Stevie Wonder hit, My Sharia Moore.
La 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 we've been working on in our Acting One class. This is half of our performers, as due to some unforeseen circumstances, some are not here. So the improv scene will truly be improv, as the two people who are about to do it didn't even know they were going to do it until today. So we'll have some fun improv and classical scenes and contemporary scenes in our Acting One showcase. Without further ado, I present the talents of Kayla Wright, Brittany Dixon, Sean Fitzmorris, and Lindsay Reed. For our first scene, which is an improv scene, we're going to be using Sean and Kayla. And we need two members of the audience who are willing to come up. I see a hand over there. I see two hands in the back. Come on up. Great. Watch your step. Welcome. What's your name?
Madison.
Nice to meet you. I'm Joshua. Stand right here. What's your name?
Ben.
Right up here. If you guys can give a round of applause for Madison and Ben. So, what Kayla and Sean are about to do is a game called Pillars. And during the game, Madison and Ben, at any time, you guys are standing here as pillars. And it's sort of like Mad Libs, in a sense. If Kayla or Sean at any time sets you up by saying a sentence such as, I'm so excited about shopping for the holidays, I really want to buy, and then they tap you, you say the first thing that comes into your mind. PG-13. I really want to buy a PS3, and then they will incorporate that into their scene. You got it, Madison? Okay, great. So, Kayla and Sean, would you guys like a who, what, or where?
Where?
They would like an environment that they can start the scene in. Is there an environment that we could get from the audience?
A rainforest.
I heard rainforest. Okay. Great. And count with me to start the scene. We'll see that scene in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
I cannot believe I am here in the rainforest with this very famous person.
Cameron Diaz.
My Cameron, you're puffed up.
Yes, I have. I have been working on my glutes and female fat zones.
You're doing a very good job, And you see you're matching the wild kind of animal up there. And it's called a
monkey.
You look just like a monkey, Cameron.
Oh, why, thank you. I'm quite flattered by that comment.
You would be, wouldn't you?
Yes, I would. Thank you. Why? Do you have a secret agenda?
I always have a secret agenda.
Oh, really?
Yes, lay down right here.
Where might that be?
Well, I don't know. What is my agenda?
To hunt.
To hunt monkeys.
Oh, hunt monkeys.
I hunt monkeys.
Oh.
I am a famous hunter. My name is...
Bill Gates! It is an honor to meet you, sire.
Thank you very much.
Yes. You are...
Cameron Diaz, you want to go hunting monkeys with me?
Why not?
All right. What are we going to use? Do you have a gun?
M16.
And what kind of weapon did I bring with me?
Nothing.
So I'm going to hunt with my bare and my teeth. You ready?
Maybe. What exactly are we hunting, though?
Monkeys.
Monkeys?
What kind?
What kind of monkeys?
Apes. Gorillas.
Isn't that illegal? Okay. I see one right there. And it is...
Eating a banana.
Eating a banana.
Get that banana. We go get it. Okay.
How are we gonna get up there? How are we gonna get up to the banana?
Climb.
We're gonna climb up to the banana.
All right.
All right. Okay. You doing good?
The monkey ran away.
It's a gorilla.
Gorilla? Were we chasing a gorilla? Oh dear.
And the gorilla looks exactly like some famous person.
Shrek.
It's Shrek.
I could have sworn it looks like
Steve Jobs.
But it looks like Steve Jobs when he's
only eating
a banana. Did you ever see Steve Jobs eat a banana?
I know, actually. I have not. I've only seen him... making computers.
With bananas?
With bananas. Oh, no, not with bananas. I haven't seen him with a banana. I just said that.
Thank you very much.
Transfer into a classical scene. Just give us a sec to set up.
Hello, everyone. I am Kayla Wright.
And I'm Brittany Dixon.
And we are performing a scene from the play Uncle Vanya, written by Anton Chekhov.
Yes, you should probably go. You probably are a good person, but there's something about
you about your entire existence. We're working away at our little jobs, we get things done, and then all of a sudden, we have to drop everything just to take care of you and your husband's gout. You and your husband, pair of you, you do nothing, and you infect us all. I fell hard for you. You know that. But I haven't done a thing in over a month, and there are a lot of sick people out there. And all the cattle are eating my saplings. Wherever you and your husband go, you destroy whatever you touch, don't you? I'm joking, of course, but still, it's funny. I know what would happen if you did stay. Complete and utter disaster. I never survive it, and you? Might not be too much fun for you either. All right, you're leaving, just go. Finita la commedia.
I'm taking a trip to Whitby as a souvenir.
It's funny, isn't it? We got to know each other so well, and now we'll never see each other again. It's the way life goes, I guess. Say, there's no Uncle Vanya around with this bunch of flowers, so let me. I want to kiss you goodbye, all right? There. That was nice.
I wish you all the best. For once in my life, why not? Okay, time to go.
Yes, the carriage is here. Just get in it and go.
Temporary scene.
My name is Sean Fitzmaurice.
And I'm Lindsay Reed, and I'll be playing the part of Brooke Wyeth.
And I'll be the part of Lyman Wyeth. This is from the play called Other Desert Cities by John Robin Bates. You have a smoke to go aside and sneak?
No. Did you quit?
I did. But it's fun to sneak them. Your mother sneaks them too. It's a little game we play. We steal each other's smokes. It's amazing what you do to entertain yourself, Fantastic.
I have pot for later.
Are you allowed to smoke pot with the antidepressants?
Sure, with a gin chaser.
It's not funny, Brooke. It really isn't. You have to be careful. Really.
Dad, one of the nice myths about pain is that one cannot truly forget. Forget it. That's why women have more than one child. Well, I'm here to tell you, Daddy, I have a very good memory of pain.
Is your throat okay?
No.
Seems sick.
A little bit.
Well, you know what? I wrote you last month, offering you money.
Yes, you did.
And you have not favored me with the courtesy of reply.
Dad, I don't need your money. My life works just the way that it is, simple and clean.
But why not? I mean, given how tenuous things are getting, I can at least make your life incrementally...
better? Money does that. Has it ever for this family? We at least know that much. Dad, please do not make this whole trip about a check from you. Got it?
So, what kind of living do you make? I mean, you know, it's great when Town and Leisure or, you know, Gourmet sends you to Sri Lanka. And God knows what you make for an editorial, but at the end of the day, it's hand to mouth.
Dad, not one of my friends, not one that gets a check from home is not crippled in some fundamental way. Please, the balance is so delicate, I can't screw with it.
But what if it happens again? The depression. You lost years. Your mother and I watched you in that hospital helplessly. Oh man, that hospital.
Look, I take the lovely pills. I go see the blessed Dr. Layton every week, twice a week. And I do yoga and I eat right. I know how to handle it.
Sorry.
Dad, look at me. I'm fine. I've been through tough times, but it's only made me stronger. I'm your daughter and I'm mom's too. Two old trees, two old oak trees, and I'm an oak too. Got it? An oak.
We all have our ways of dealing. You might just become overprotective later in life. You seem to fail to remember that I lost a child. I'm not able to relax around my other two.
You can't live like that.
It's collateral damage. I wouldn't expect you to know what that feels like.
How can you say that I don't know what that feels like? I lost my brother, my best friend. You know I don't make friends easily. He was my whole world, and then he was just gone.
You still miss him?
Every day, all day, most of the day.
For me, it's the holidays. Around Christmas, I think of your brother. I think of him. I think about time, about what's left. You'd think it would have been forgotten by now.
Just because you and Mom moved to the desert does not mean that anybody without a computer cannot look up and see what happened to his family in a matter of moments. It's part of who we are. We can't just pretend it never happened.
A lot of people go through the entirety of their lives pretending. At the end of the day, it's not the worst thing you can do.
I've tried living like that, and I just can't. I have to actually talk about it. Not in code, not obliquely. We have never...
I can't! Maybe it's the old actor in me. I like to have my lines written down. You know, sometimes I see myself late at night on TV, grimacing with a 45 in my hand, arresting somebody. It was so much simpler then.
You should have stayed an actor. You were so handsome.
Yeah, but it mortified me. You just look good in a suit. I'm broken. I think everything is so funny. Even when you were blue, twinkle. Now, can't help it. Twinkle just isn't there.
the Waterstone side of it in Brown and the Dalvin. I think I can speak for the working with such inspiring words of art that really makes my job feel worthwhile. I would like to invite everyone to share pizza and tea and lemonade with us outside in the lobby. And if anyone has any questions about the financial program or the classes that we're offering here, please speak to any of the instructors or to me or to Joy Lester.